Hello, this is Martin Cohen, founder of Latin Percussion, LP. I already had developed the bongo, and the next order of instruments that was logical was a conga. And all the congas at the time, except for a few, were made out of wood. There was one maker of fiberglass drums, kind of a small maker, a boutique kind of guy. I had heard from somebody who came to my office that there was a molder of fiberglass in Long Island City, and I went to see them. It's called Nova Glass. And they made the fiberglass shells for me that became my most significant product in terms of visibility. At the time, you know, it was kind of looked upon as, well, maybe not the authentic warm sound of wood. But it turned out during the period that it had its greatest popularity, that its sound was louder and brighter, which was important for cutting through the loud salsa bands. And it became quite a hit. All was going well with this 30-inch tall fiberglass conga, when one day I got a shipment that looked peculiar in that it was shorter. It was shorter by 2 inches. I think I was getting maybe 30 a week. Was a lot of drums for me. I called him, I said, your drums are too short, take it back. He says, I'm not taking it back. And this was a small company. He said, you either take it, keep it, or not doing business. I was not in any position to do otherwise. As it turned out, the shorter conga was particularly appreciated by the sit-down salsa conga drummer. Back in those days, all the conga drummers sat down. And by accident, the 28-inch tall conga became the most desirable for quite a number of years.